fight against Alzheimer's has shown that many factors can contribute to cognitive decline and other types of dementia, but one study is focused on learning more about how some people age gracefully and stay sharp past their 80s. A new CNN Digital report details the work researchers at Northwestern are doing to understand more about SuperAgers. Those are people, they're elderly people with brains as sharp as 20s and 30s. People are in 20 and 30 years younger than them. So joining me now, Emily Rogalsksi she's a cognitive neuroscientist who developed the SuperAger project. She's also a professor of psychiatry and behavioral sciences at Northwestern Feinberg School of Medicine. We're so happy that you could join us. Thank you very much. Good morning to you. The big question here, do these people do anything, I want to know, to keep sharp, to keep young, to help their memories, or is it just kind of who they are?
Good morning. Thanks for having me today. That's the million-dollar question, is what are the factors that allow SuperAgers to maintain this great memory performance? And we look at this from multiple perspectives. One thing we do see, kind of related to your last segment, is that SuperAgers tend to endorse stronger relationships with others. So they like to stay connected. So they're trying to avoid that social isolation and loneliness that you were just speaking of.
And Emily, a big part of this, when I was looking at your project and what it actually looks like, is the difference is not just in intelligence here. It's not just if you're a smarter person, you have a higher IQ, that you are more likely to be a SuperAger. It's really about those other factors.
That's right. So we're looking at multiple factors here to understand what might contribute to the SuperAging phenotype. How is it that they are socially active? What do their brains look like? Can we measure their biologic age from different perspectives in addition to already knowing their chronologic age? And in general, we see that the SuperAgers tend to be more youthful. They look younger. Their brains look a little bit more like 50 to 60-year-olds than they do like their 80-plus-year-old peers.
Okay, so one of the other traits I saw here that was interesting to me is they tend to be positive, right? So optimists and social butterflies, not homebodies. True?
The SuperAgers in general tend to be very busy. Some of them are still working. Others have picked up a second career later in life. And then still others are volunteering. So they're busy folks. And we're really appreciative that they take time out of their day to come and spend time with us so that we can learn more about their secrets.
But you said it's only 10%. And so there are no curmudgeons among the group.
There's all kinds of personalities that walk through our doors, but we see that really less than 10% of people who think that they have outstanding memory performance end up meeting criteria. So we really think of this as a relatively rare group, but that's important because it can teach us about specialized factors and features that might be helpful for avoiding disease and disability and extending health span.
Can you
live long and well.
Can you make yourself one of these people? Like, naturally, these people were naturally that way. Can you, like, say, I'm going to do all of these things and all of a sudden turn into a SuperAger?
Yeah, so the goal is that we're starting to think about risk factors for SuperAgers instead of risk factors for Alzheimer's disease. How do we set ourselves up so that we're stacking up our protective factors and minimizing our risk factors? And so this study is going to help us identify, this program is going to help us identify those factors that are really important. Some of them may be modifiable, where others may be the things that we're born with. We don't have any choice over the parents and the genetics that we have, but we do have a lot of other choice in our biologic aging.
Yeah. It's absolutely fascinating. Emily, thank you for your work on this, and thanks for bringing it to our audience this morning.
Thanks, Emily.
You can read more about SuperAgers on CNN.com if you're as interested as we were in that.
Great.
And this